No, ordinance can never suffice because ordinance is only a temporary affair. It has to be replaced by legislation. That legislation will have to be brought to Parliament, and I assume in the circumstances in which it will come, it will not have to be referred to the Standing Committee, but that's the consent of the House. At present, there is legislation which is with Standing Committee, and the Standing Committee may approve the very legislation or suggest the very legislation that we think is required to replace the ordinance. Mm-hmm. So the ordinance was done in response to a sense of urgency that was felt in the streets by young people who just felt betrayed and felt that something should be done immediately.
Right.
And that's also the impression that we got from the report of Chief Justice
Verma,
that there has to be some urgency in addressing the problem.
Right.
So we brought the ordinance, but the ordinance will have to be replaced by legislation, and we'll have to go through the parliamentary procedure, but at least nobody can distract now by saying that there is no intention to do anything. Our intention has been made clear.
Right.
The quality and the nature of the legislation that replaces the ordinance will be there for the parliamentarians to see and then decide.
Salman Saab, it was really nice talking to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
In our next episode, we will again come back with a special person. Keep watching Lok Sabha Television.
एक कारोबार में देरी के लिए कोई जगह नहीं तो देश की तरक्की में देरी कैसी है इसलिए मैं समय पर सही सेवा कर चुकाता हूँ
Enhancing beauty is my profession, but I also contribute to beautify my nation. I pay my service tax. Do you pay?
मैं सर्विस टैक्स भरता हूँ उसी भी पर मुल्क की तरक्की में अपना हिस्सा पाओ
हमारा बढ़ता कारोबार बने देश की प्रगति का आधार
समय पर सही सेवा कर चुकाए
जिंदगी के खेल में भी जीतने के लिए आपके लाडले को चाहिए आपकी समझ और एक भरोसेमंद साथी LIC Children's Plans जिंदगी भर जीत का वादा
बैंकिंग तो एक झमेला है यार
इलाहाबाद बैंक का सेविंग्स बैंक अकाउंट ट्राई करो उनके पास है नेट बैंकिंग टैक्स और बिलों का ऑनलाइन पेमेंट RTGS और NEFT द्वारा तुरंत फंड ट्रांसफर इंटरनेशनल डेबिट कम ATM कार्ड फोन बैंकिंग
अरे वाह
बैंकिंग अब चुटकी में यार
इलाहाबाद बैंक
हर कदम आपके साथ
अरे मैच इतनी जल्दी खत्म हो गया
कोई आया ही नहीं सब छुट्टियों में घूमने गए
अब हम कब जाएंगे
मुझे भी जाना है पापा
हम भी छुट्टियों में घूमने जाएंगे
पक्का पापा
पक्का
थैंक यू
आपने झूठा वादा क्यों किया घर की EMI देने के बाद कुछ बचता है क्या
झूठा नहीं सच्चा वादा है क्योंकि मैंने अपना होम लोन स्टेट बैंक में शिफ्ट कर दिया है EMI बहुत कम हो गया है
सच
अब बचत ही बचत EMI हुआ कम घूमने चले हम
मिस्टर फुकन पेशे से अकाउंटेंट हिसाब किताब में माहिर हर प्रकार की चोरी पकड़ सकते हैं पर एक चोरी तो लगातार हो रही है इनकी दृष्टि की और वो चोर है काला मोतिया या ग्लूकोमा चश्मे का नंबर बार बार बदलना आंखों में तेज दर्द नजर का दायरा कम होना रोशनी में रंगीन गोले दिखाई देना ये सभी काला मोतिया के लक्षण हैं। इन लक्षणों को नजरअंदाज ना करें और नेत्र विशेषज्ञ से अवश्य जांच करवाएं। याद रहे देरी होने पर नजर हमेशा के लिए जा सकती है अधिक जानकारी के लिए निकट के सरकारी अस्पताल एवं स्वयंसेवी संस्थाओं से संपर्क करें
ये पानी मेरा है
मेरा है
नहीं मेरा है
तेरा मेरा मत कर सासू ये पानी तो सबका है
मुश्किल हल होगी हम सबको ये सोचना है
पानी बर्बाद नहीं करेंगे,
थोड़ा थोड़ा इस्तेमाल करेंगे।
ऐसे भविष्य से बचने के लिए पानी बर्बाद ना करें और बारिश के पानी का संरक्षण करें।
आत्महत्या की बात की आपने किसानों की, क्या सबसे बड़ी वजह है ऐसी घटनाओं की जो होती है खासतौर से आपके प्रदेश में महाराष्ट्र में?
दिन ब दिन उर्वरक हो या डीजल हो, डीजल या मजदूरी हो, इसकी कीमतें बढ़ती जा रही है, आसमान को छूती जा रही है और लागत मूल्य से भी कम दाम मिल रहे हैं किसानों को। और इसका परिणाम ये हो रहा है कि खर्चा ज्यादा और उत्पादन कम।
वॉच नो योर एमपी फ्राइडे 8:30 PM ओनली ऑन लोकसभा टेलीविजन।
एक कोशिश औरत के आंगन में झांकने की, एक पहल उसके नजरिए को समझने की, एक कदम औरत के एहसास को संवाद देने की ओर, एक कार्यक्रम जो हर हफ्ते रूबरू कराएगा औरत की बदलती पहचान से। जानेंगे क्यों है जद्दोजहद आंचल में आकाश को समाने की। तो देखना ना भूलें हर शनिवार रात 8:30 आंचल में आकाश, सिर्फ लोकसभा टीवी पर।
Speed Boost, binding the whole world in one thread. With its fast, secure, economical and reliable delivery system that reaches in India and across the globe. Speed Boost from India Post. Discover the joy of communication.
Bhai saab, aapne bijli ka bill ab tak nahi bhara? Kab bharenge sir? Telephone ka bill bhara? वो कब भरेंगे सर?
बेटा मनी ट्रांसफर अब तक नहीं हुआ, कब भेजोगे? जल्दी करो ना बेटा।
पापा पापा, आप मेरा मोबाइल टॉप अप भूले तो नहीं ना? मुझे अभी चाहिए,
अभी के अभी।
क्या आप टेंशन फ्री लाइफ जीना चाहते हैं? अब अपने मोबाइल फोन से स्टेट बैंक फ्रीडम पे लॉग ऑन करके कीजिए पैसा ट्रांसफर, मोबाइल टॉप अप, बिल्स पेमेंट। स्टेट बैंक फ्रीडम, तो हुआ ना आपका बैंक आपकी जेब में।
क्यों किया?
समझो।
जिंदगी के खेल में भी जीतने के लिए आपके लाडले को चाहिए आपकी समझ और एक भरोसेमंद साथी। LIC चिल्ड्रंस प्लान्स, जिंदगी भर जीत का वादा।
तकनीकी सलाह लेकर घर बनाया, इसलिए ये सलामत है, वरना आज ही अपना भूकंप जोन जानिए और किसी स्ट्रक्चरल इंजीनियर से सलाह लीजिए। भूकंप में घर सुरक्षित तो आप सुरक्षित। आपके हित में तत्पर NDMA।
कितनी चीनी? 1.5 चम्मच?
नहीं, मेरे लिए नहीं, मुझे डायबिटीज है।
आपने अपनी खान पान की आदतों को नियंत्रण में रखा है, ये अच्छा है। मधुमेह के रोगी के लिए ये बहुत जरूरी है।
जरूरी है?
हाँ, मधुमेह का असर सारे शरीर पर होता है, खास तौर पर आंखों पर, इससे अंधे भी हो सकते हैं।
यदि आपको डायबिटीज है तो दृष्टि सुरक्षा पर अवश्य ध्यान दें, समय समय पर नेत्र विशेषज्ञ से अपनी आंखों की जांच करवाएं।
अरे छत पे क्या कर रहे हो?
बारिश के लिए उपाय कर रहा हूँ।
पर एक बात और है जिसका उपाय जल्दी ही निकालना पड़ेगा। दीदी ने कहा है प्रसव के 42 दिन के बाद अगर मैं कॉपर टी लगाऊं तो बिना दर्द के हम आसानी से 10 साल तक या जब तक चाहे सुरक्षा पा सकते हैं। इससे मासिक धर्म या संबंध में कोई परेशानी नहीं, और तो और जब बच्चा चाहो तब कॉपर टी आसानी से निकलवा सकते हो। और हाँ, 3 साल का अंतर रखोगे तो माँ और बच्चा दोनों स्वस्थ रहेंगे।
पति पत्नी करें विचार, स्वस्थ नारी स्वस्थ परिवार।
आत्महत्या की बात की आपने किसानों की, क्या सबसे बड़ी वजह है ऐसी घटनाओं की जो होती है खासतौर से आपके प्रदेश में महाराष्ट्र में?
दिन ब दिन उर्वरक हो या डीजल हो, डीजल या मजदूरी हो, इसकी कीमतें बढ़ती जा रही है, आसमान को छूती जा रही है और लागत मूल्य से भी कम दाम मिल रहे हैं किसानों को। और इसका परिणाम ये हो रहा है कि खर्चा ज्यादा और उत्पादन कम।
वॉच नो योर एमपी फ्राइडे 8:30 PM ओनली ऑन लोकसभा टेलीविजन।
लीडर्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड
आर विद अ वेरी स्पेशल पर्सन,
देयर पॉलिसीज
वी हैव
necessary infrastructure in place.
Their views.
India is a successful story.
We need to give serious attention.
Latest issues. Questions that matter.
Trade between Commonwealth countries and all. There is no growth as such.
Answers for the people.
Block level. Aam janta se sampark karke.
These small parties are coming up.
Broadening the conversation.
We don't have to destroy it to the constitutional apparatus.
Unki apeksha bahut badi hai.
In talks with Rajiv Mishra every Saturday 8 p.m. in special guest only on Lok Sabha Television.
Watch Agenda, a live discussion from the studio of Lok Sabha Television. On Agenda Before the House, a glimpse at the day's schedule in Lok Sabha. Monday to Friday, 10 a.m.
India, a nation of unity in diversity, with its rich culture, heritage, traditions and a lot more. Watch ingenious documentaries presented by Lok Sabha Television and sponsored by Publicity Division, Ministry of External Affairs on India Unlimited. Thursdays at 6:30 p.m.
Very warm welcome to this edition of Agenda. In Agenda today, we are going to analyze the Union Budget that was presented yesterday in the Lok Sabha. And apart from that, in the Agenda today, a lot of other things are listed. Questions relating to the Ministry of Women and Child Development, to the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, Panchayati Raj, Health and Family Welfare. And apart from that, the Home Minister is also likely to make a statement on the Bhandara rape incident in Maharashtra and supplementary demands for grants, railways and other things, including the private members' business, is also listed in today's list of business. But let's start the discussion on the Union Budget first. I'm joined by Mr. Vaijin Panda from the Biju Janata Dal and Mr. Dr. Kirit Bhai Solanki from the BJP. And we'll be very shortly joined by Mr. Madhu Gauri Yashki from the Congress. Let's start the discussion with you, Mr. Panda. Since much has been said about this particular budget, whether it was a populist budget or a reformist budget, but politically, how do you really look at this budget?
You know, if you listen to the commentators on television all day yesterday, and if you look at the newspapers today, a lot of people in the financial sector, in the corporate sector, they seem to have been expecting and bracing for something far worse. And you can see a palpable sense of relief that it is not far worse. And in fact, the finance minister very explicitly stated that the economy is in a mess and there has to be curbs on expenditure and there is a desperate need for investment. And the whole idea seemed to be to provide a safe budget which doesn't scare off investors, which doesn't scare off the markets. But in fact, if you see the result, the response by this very constituency to whom he was primarily appealing has been very lukewarm. Yesterday, the first day's reaction in the market was very lukewarm, very tepid. So I think you can say that it has not really succeeded in sending that message that we need the investment, we are going to roll out the red carpet for investment. It hasn't succeeded. And the reason for that is, while there has been no real increase in allocations across the board, with a few exceptions, if you adjust for inflation, NREGA and others are actually the same or less if you adjust for inflation.
Right.
But at the same time, some noises have been made that sound populist. For example, there is now an announcement that if the food security bill passes, there's 10,000 crores set aside for it. reality is 10,000 crores is not going to achieve any kind of food security. So on the one hand, you're making populist sounding noises. On the other hand, you're trying to send a signal to the markets, don't worry, we are not really going to spend anything significant on that.
Yeah.
So you're sending a crossed signal. You're trying to send two kinds of signals, and I think that is confusing the situation. If you really wanted to go for a fiscally sound budget, if you want to really get the GDP back up to 6.7% as they say they want to,
yeah,
then you should have sent an unambiguous message that we are going to swallow all the bitter pills now. We are not going to worry about political pressures, not going to worry about elections, and really do the sound economic decision. They haven't done that. They've done that only in a half measure. So they are, you know, they're neither getting the populist benefit, nor are they getting the kind of strong support from the financial sector which they were hoping for.
Hmm.
So it becomes sort of an in-between budget.
Okay. So does it make it a very political budget?
See, it is in one way it is political also, because the election is impending 2014. The finance minister has tried to give the political sort of a promises and all these things. He miserably failed in this budget. It is neither populist nor it is going to help any economical boost up also. It's a presentation of a gift in a beautiful gift package. A bajigari hai, in a beautiful package, but the content is, I think, nothing is there. There is nothing for women, there is nothing for young, there is nothing for poor. This budget is project purely on the women's, considering the women's, youth and poor. They have failed on all the aspects. See, they have for the recently there were incidents of rape and atrocities on the women's. So they have put a Nirbhaya fund, 1,000 crore Nirbhaya fund. See, that the population of our country is 121 crore population. If you imagine, nearly 50% also, then more than 55 crores are the females.
Hmm.
And what is the contribution for females in this budget? The for youth also, there is no employment thing.
Nothing
is there in the budget
jobs
is also.
For
and for to remove the poverty, garibo ke liye kiya hai. There is nothing is there to remove the poverty.
Okay,
it is absolutely a failure budget.
Fine. So you believe that it was, it talks a lot about a lot of things, but it delivers very little. We'll have a view from the Congress too on this. Time for a very short break. After the break, Mr. Yashki from the INC will join us.
आत्महत्या की बात की आपने किसानों की, क्या सबसे बड़ी वजह है ऐसी घटनाओं की जो होती हैं, खासतौर से आपके प्रदेश में महाराष्ट्र में?
दिन ब दिन उर्वरक हो या डीजल या मजदूरी हो, इसकी कीमतें बढ़ती जा रही है, आसमान को छूती जा रही है, और लागत मूल्य से भी कम दाम मिल रहे हैं किसानों को, और इसका परिणाम ये हो रहा है कि खर्चा ज्यादा और उत्पादन कम.
वॉच नो योर एमपी फ्राइडे 8:30 PM only on Lok Sabha Television.
एक कोशिश औरत के आंगन में झांकने की, एक पहल उसके नजरिए को समझने की, एक कदम औरत के एहसास को संवाद देने की ओर, एक कार्यक्रम जो हर हफ्ते रूबरू कराएगा औरत की बदलती पहचान से. जानेंगे क्यों है जद्दोजहद आंचल में आकाश को समाने की. तो देखना ना भूलें हर शनिवार रात 8:30 PM आंचल में आकाश, सिर्फ लोकसभा टीवी पर.
Leaders around the world.
I'm with a very special person.
Their policies.
We have the necessary infrastructure in place.
Their views.
India is a successful story.
We need to give serious attention.
Latest issues.
Questions
that matter.
Trade between Commonwealth countries and all. There is no growth
as such.
Answers for the people.
Block level, aam janta se sampark karke.
These small parties are coming up.
Broadening the conversation.
We don't have to destroy it to the constitutional apparatus.
Unki apeksha hai bahut badi.
In talks with Rajiv Mishra every Saturday 8 p.m. in special guest only on Lok Sabha Television.
आत्महत्या की बात की आपने किसानों की, क्या सबसे बड़ी वजह है ऐसी घटनाओं की जो होती है खासतौर से आपके प्रदेश में महाराष्ट्र में?
दिन ब दिन उर्वरक हो या डीजल या मजदूरी हो, इसकी कीमतें बढ़ती जा रही है, आसमान को छूती जा रही है और लागत मूल्य से भी कम दाम मिल रहे हैं किसानों को और इसका परिणाम ये हो रहा है कि खर्चा ज्यादा और उत्पादन कम।
वॉच नो योर एमपी फ्राइडे 8:30 PM only on Lok Sabha Television.
Are men from Mars
and women from Venus?
Who is the better half?
Who takes the decisions?
Who is responsible?
Who is demanding?
Who is submissive?
Who is independent?
Can men and women ever find common ground? To find out, watch Gender Discourse every Thursday 4 PM only on Lok Sabha Television.
Banking तो एक झमेला है यार।
इलाहाबाद बैंक का सेविंग्स बैंक अकाउंट ट्राई करो, उनके पास है नेट बैंकिंग, टैक्स और बिलों का ऑनलाइन पेमेंट, RTGS और NEFT द्वारा तुरंत फंड ट्रांसफर, इंटरनेशनल डेबिट कम ATM कार्ड, फोन बैंकिंग।
अरे वाह, बैंकिंग अब चुटकी में यार।
इलाहाबाद बैंक।
मेरे कारोबार में देरी के लिए कोई जगह नहीं तो देश की तरक्की में देरी कैसी, इसलिए मैं समय पर सही सेवा कर चुकाता हूँ।
Enhancing beauty is my profession, but I also contribute to beautify my nation. I pay my service tax. Do you pay?
मैं service tax पढ़ता हूँ, उसी भी पढ़ो कि मुल्क की तरक्की में अपना हिस्सा पाओ।
हमारा बढ़ता कारोबार बने देश की प्रगति का आधार।
समय पर सही सेवा कर चुकाए।
Welcome back to Agenda. The Finance Minister presented the Union Budget for 2013 and 14 yesterday, and before going into the break we were talking about the different aspects of the budget as to how the representatives from various political parties look at this budget. At this point of time we are joined by Mr. Madhukar Yasky from the Congress. Mr. Yasky, we would like to know it from you, since both the parties, from the BJD and BJP, have expressed their views as to how they look at this budget. Well, the commoners are, you know, even the analysts look at it not as a very middle class friendly budget. How would you define this budget, sir? What, according to you, was this like?
As Home Minister rightly said it, this budget is for the future of India, not keeping any political interest or advantage for the party or government. So look at this, the concentration where he made it, allocating more funds for the youth and women and poor, and plus the rural sector, rural development to agriculture sector. So this clearly indicates this growth should continue. Plus, while growth is continuing, we should not left out those groups which is left it.
Hmm.
The women, poor and rural, concentration given into those sectors so that growth should be inclusive growth. We know that there were 300 million people, still though GDP growth is 5, 6, 7, whatever, but still millions of people left out and we need to take care of them. And growth should continue without further burdening on the poor.
Hmm.
Little burden on the rich, and the budget is very balanced, trying to balance the deficit, and it's a more responsible budget, I feel, and thinking future of the country.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Panda, again, the belief here is, since you said that probably they could have really done better, you know, as many would call it, it was high on intent, low on substance. They've touched and left a few subjects, whether it's about women or it's about youth. As we're talking about jobs, don't you think it's a little, it's little difficult to understand? The economic survey comes and it says that the second chapter of the economic survey is dedicated only on the demographic dividend, how to seize the demographic dividend. But the budget, to an extent, is silent as to how it is going to really create those jobs.
As I said, if you look overall, the budget is neither whole hog reformist nor is it populist. It's a bit of both, and that's the problem. It doesn't send a clear message. It sends mixed signals. And you're right about the demographics. Look, whatever has been done for women and for youth, I welcome it. But if you take a hard look at it, these are token sums. You know, 1,000 crore here and 1,000 crore there, when you are talking about 16 lakh crores of expenditure in the total budget. This is tokenism. It's not going to make a huge change. Now, if you wanted to make a huge change, let's say on the issue of women, I've been promoting an idea, some other MPs also, that we have the lowest ratio of judges to population in the world, a fraction of what developed countries have. We need to invest much more to have fast-track courts throughout the country for crimes against women, and I've also been suggesting for criminal cases of elected politicians. Because, you know, there is the general sense of dismay at the number of people with criminal cases that get elected. So if you can have fast-track courts, these are things where a few thousand crores would have made a huge difference to the way our politics functions, to the safety of women, to the entire sense of well-being and change and improvement. And if you are going to talk about the underprivileged, you know, I come from Odisha, and the KBK districts in Odisha are known as the face of deprivation in the country. Nothing. No, whatever was there, the small amount of funding that was there for it, the same thing continues, nothing significant. We got disappointed earlier in the week when the railway budget totally ignored states like Odisha. We have 8 districts that have no railways at all, no investment. Odisha gives the railways 14,000 crores of gross earnings. And we expect at least 1,000 crores to be reinvested, particularly where in tribal areas you have no railways and that is where you have naxalism. That didn't happen. So we were hoping at least there would be an extra special fund. Like, we recognize that there's some funding put aside for RIDF and all that. But this is generally for the whole country. If you are talking about specifically underprivileged people, then we have 10 million people who are tribals in Odisha who have no railways. At least you can give them some extra funding for not just a few watersheds, but major irrigation projects. You did not hear the word irrigation in the entire budget. So, you know, if you wanted to be reformist, you should have gone whole hog and you should have got the financial sector excited, because as the FM pointed out, you desperately need investment. You need $75 billion of investment just to manage the current account deficit. And yet, you make a half-hearted attempt to get that.
But so, Jay, look at those Naxal-affected districts, even covers, Orissa covers under that, the BRGF fund and area.
That's the point I'm making. The BRGF fund has remained unchanged. No. And it's a token. It's 1,000 crores for 3-4 states. So, you know, if we've got 10 million, 1 crore tribals in Odisha alone. And these are districts that don't have railways. These are districts that don't have industry. These are districts that don't have enough irrigation. These are districts where you have
naxalism. Agriculture. But even if you take the farm loan from 5 lakh 75 thousand, 7 lakh crores, this farm credit which farmers are...
My point is...
Access to the...
My point
the
is the emphasis that the FM was saying, that we need growth, but we need to pay special emphasis to deprived sections. So what I'm saying is, whatever special emphasis has been given to deprived sections, like women, like the students, like BRGF fund, these are token sums.
Token sums.
More should have been done if you really mean that. Now, if you don't mean that, if you say, look, we have to, if we have to tighten our belt, we can't spend this money, then you should have sent the opposite message, very strong message to the markets, and you have to somehow raise $75 billion just to stop the current account deficit. Now, you have sent a half-hearted message to both sides, to the Aam Aadmi also half-hearted, to the financial markets also half-hearted.
Okay.
That's the problem.
Dr. Solanki, there were 2-3 important things here. One being, of course, the crop diversification program. I'm only quoting what famous agriculture scientist Dr. M.S. Swaminathan has said about this particular budget. He said that the crop diversification program is a good thing since it will be happening in certain areas, and of course the extension of the green revolution to the eastern India, that is also an interesting thing which he has said. And the National Livestock Mission, For years we've been thinking of this kind of a mission. Finally, the government has proposed a very little sum, just 307 crore rupees, that at least it will lead to some sort of launching of this particular mission. How do you look at these aspects too of the budget?
See, the finance minister has, in this budget, it is purely the tokenism. They have touched the issue, but they have not touched with the intention to have a revolution. And I personally feel that the finance minister has missed a golden opportunity. See, this was a time when Indian economy is not in a good shape. It is sinking economy. Our GDP is it is around 5%. So he should have done a little bit more aggressive steps also. Regarding this this food security, see, the cash transfer also, it's there is nothing new in this cash transfer. See, they are taking all the claims, they are making the claims, and they are we have transferred the money in the hands of the needy people. See, the all the schemes are at present also, it is in execution, all the schemes. So it is, there is nothing new in this scheme.
You don't think
also
that the direct benefit transfer scheme is going to be any sort of game changer?
No, but it is already people are getting. It is already people are getting. They have not done any infrastructure also.
They are planning to replace it with cash now. I mean, instead of the goods this time, it is going to be replaced by cash.
Instead of giving cash, they are getting through checks. They are getting through subsidy in the cylinders. They are getting subsidies in fertilizer also. Now everything has been fertilizer subsidy is removed. That cylinder is also there. They have made a capping over the cylinder. So it is increasing the price rise, and the issue of price rise is not at all addressed in this budget. In fact, see, the price rise in a diesel, I can't understand the economy. See, the leading economist is there, Manmohan Singh ji, our Prime Minister, and Chidambaram ji also. The buyers of the diesel, in the retail buyers, there is a 50% increase for a retail buyer. Those who are the bulk consumers, like railway or state transports or any public transport, there is a 12 rupees increase. So what is the economy? If you buy more, if you buy in a bulk, then always it should be cheaper. Here it is a reverse thing, and it is going to have the price rise. They are not going to address the price rise issue. In spite of doing all these things, the price rise will continue, and this government has miserably failed to address the issue of price rise.
Okay, Mr. Yasky, here I would like to know, since your government, in fact, the finance minister also used this quote yesterday, aapka paisa aapke haath, that is, it's more about the direct benefit transfer scheme. Much has been said about this particular scheme, but the structural issue being, we don't really have that strong banking infrastructure in the rural setup. Even the post offices are not really equipped to handle the kind of transfer, the kind of system you would like to really have or see in future. Don't you see that those are the issues which have not been really addressed to the extent that it could have been by the government?
Look, he did address the postal issues. Before quickly answering that, let me disagree with my friends here. It's not a tokenism. My friends are forgetting the allocations which is allotted in the rural development. The 80,000 crores like PMGSY to agriculture loan credit which is available to the people, which women force is also there. So it's not just, they're only quoting those 1,000 crores additional for women and youth. This is additional other than given for the minority, women and other sectors, which is already included. So these are additional concentration on women and youth. So the question what you're saying, direct transfer, the post offices, finance minister yesterday did mention how to strengthen the post offices also working like a banks. And those are easy access to the remotest areas. So we did understand those problems, trying to fix that. Banks, yes, the direct transfer you need to either to the post office or to the banks. And we are forcing the nationalized banks, private banks all to set up their branches in the rural areas too. So while taking into that into consideration and having access how to deliver this direct cash transfer to the needy or beneficiaries through the strengthening the post offices also, enough fund allocated to that. Health and education, more funds is given. So this includes these section societies who are left out. So it's not just the tokenism, but it's we mean business. We mean seriously, taking it seriously. And other quick reply to my friend from BJP, the lowest GDP growth what we are witnessing here, this highest than when their term as NDA when they were in power. If you look at the worldwide, where French president was here, he was fighting from negative, see that their country doesn't go into the negative growth. Where we are from 9% to still 5.7, still higher than many countries. And we have potential to become the fifth largest economy in the world. To see that, we have two fiscal deficits to be balanced. And growth should continue.
Ms. Pandav.
First, let me talk about the cash transfer issue. You know, I want to disagree with my friend from Gujarat on the following basis. The problem with the benefits that the government has been giving to citizens all over the country is that we spend far more than we deliver. For all of the benefits that we are talking about, whether it is LPG, whether it is food, whether it is kerosene, the government spends 3 rupees to deliver 1 rupee worth of benefit to citizens. In fact, in the PDS, the Planning Commission's own figure is that for every 1 rupee spent, the citizen gets benefit of only 27 paisa.
Hmm.
In Rajiv Gandhi's time, it used to be 15 paisa. So it has gone up to 27 paisa. So there's a huge wastage, and you need to find ways to overcome that. Now, I have strongly supported cash transfers, and some states have been experimenting with it. The problem is, everybody knows that this government delayed cash transfers for many years because of internal infighting between various ministries. And if it had been done 3 years ago, 4 years ago, even 2 years ago, today you could have drastically cut the costs while improving the benefits to the citizens. Fiscal deficit would have been much better, and all the other objectives would have been met. Now what has happened, suddenly at the fag end, after 9 years in government, this government suddenly sees the light and says, okay, now we have overspent, now we need to cut the wastage and start cash transfers. The problem is exactly that. The infrastructure to deliver cash transfers needs 2-3 years to be put into place.
Right.
Now you're trying to do in the space of 1 year what should have been done in 3 or 4 years. Apart from post office and banks, you cannot build that many bank branches in the rural areas.
Right.
There are other innovative ideas. Nandan Nilekani is talking about micro ATMs, small ATMs, which will be in every kirana dukan, every chai shop, where subcontracted out, and there'll be competition so that those vendors can't cheat the citizens. These are all good ideas, but you need 2-3 years to put that into place, and that hasn't happened. So what's going to happen now? You are only able to roll out cash transfers in certain places which already have got enrollment of Aadhaar and already have bank branches. So states like Odisha and all and other states are missing out. You know, in my constituency in Kendrapada, forget about villages, we have block headquarters that don't have banks. So so in this time frame, it is going to be very difficult to roll out in the manner that they are talking about without politicizing it. Now that brings me to the last point here. So in principle we support, but in practice it requires time which this government no longer has.
Right.
Now the point is this: yesterday the FM asked, who can have an objection to the slogan, aapka paisa aapke haath? Now look, as I told you just now, I have no objection to the principle, but that slogan, everybody knows, is a cleverly disguised way of politicking the issue, politicizing the issue. Because you know, the slogan involves the symbol of one political party.
Hmm.
Now, we should stay away from these kind of politicizations. If you want to actually save big amounts of money while improving the benefits to the citizen, then you need to get the support across the political spectrum. You should not politicize this important issue. And that's the only way that they can actually cut costs while improving benefits.
Right. So, of course, much has been said about this particular scheme too, which the government really wants to bring. But there are certain structural issues which have to be addressed before anything really appears to be happening on the ground. Time for a short break in Agenda. Please stay tuned for more.
कुपोषण के खिलाफ जंग छिड़ चुकी है, ताकि हमारे देश का भविष्य, हमारे बच्चों का भविष्य मजबूत हो सके। तो आइए मेरे साथ मिलकर कहिए, कुपोषण भारत छोड़ो।
Raindrops are falling on my head, जैसे कोई प्यार की फुहार छुए मुझे।
बारिश का मजा तो सब लेते हैं, पर बारिश का पानी बचाने की बात कौन सोचता है? बारिश के पानी का संरक्षण करें और जिंदगी का यूं ही मजा लेते रहें।
क्या आपका फ्लैट भूकंप से सुरक्षित है? नया फ्लैट खरीदते वक्त किसी स्ट्रक्चरल इंजीनियर से सलाह लें। क्या यहाँ सॉइल टेस्टिंग किया गया है? क्या घर नेशनल बिल्डिंग कोड के मुताबिक बना है? याद रहे, घर सुरक्षित तो आप सुरक्षित। आपके हित में तत्पर NDMA।
Speed Boost, binding the whole world in one thread. With its fast, secure, economical and reliable delivery system that reaches in India and across the globe. Speed Boost from India Post. Discover the joy of communication.
Na piche hum dekhe, aage badhe chale. Hum kam nahi kisi se, har koi jaan le. Duniya ke har maqam pe hamari baat ho. Badhe chalo, badhe chalo, badhe chalo. Oonche se bhi oonche, hamari aan hai. Aasmaan se oonche, hamari shaan. चलो बढ़ी चलो बढ़ी चलो सृष्टि का आधार है नारी का आभार समाज का विकास हमारी शक्ति का आभास दुनिया के हर हृदय में हमारी जीत हो बढ़ी चलो बढ़ी चलो बढ़ी चलो बढ़ी चलो बढ़ी चलो बढ़ी चलो
मिस्टर फुकन पेशे से अकाउंटेंट हिसाब किताब में माहिर हर प्रकार की चोरी पकड़ सकते हैं पर एक चोरी तो लगातार हो रही है इनकी दृष्टि की और वो चोर है काला मोतिया या ग्लूकोमा चश्मे का नंबर बार बार बदलना आंखों में तेज दर्द नजर का दायरा कम होना रोशनी में रंगीन गोले दिखाई देना ये सभी काला मोतिया के लक्षण हैं इन लक्षणों को नजरअंदाज ना करें और नेत्र विशेषज्ञ से अवश्य जांच करवाएं याद रहे देरी होने पर नजर हमेशा के लिए जा सकती है अधिक जानकारी के लिए निकट के सरकारी अस्पताल एवं स्वयंसेवी संस्थाओं से संपर्क करें
Welcome back to Agenda. In the question hour today, some important questions relating to the rural electrification program as well as the e-governance in panchayats are listed. These are all relating to, of course, the development in the rural sector. Let's start the discussion with the remote village electrification program. Dr. Kirit Solanki, since we were talking about the budgetary allocations made for agriculture, also for the rural infrastructure in the country. How do you look at the power sector and the whole process of rural electrification under various schemes that is being carried out in various parts of the country?
See, for any country, the power is the important thing for progress of the country. The inclusive development of the country is only because of power. And we get the power source from different things. The finance minister has addressed this issue, so I welcome it also. But I will give the example because I am coming from representing Ahmedabad constituency from Gujarat. See, in Gujarat, the earlier Gujarat was a power deficient state. Within a decade period, the Gujarat has become a power surplus state. Now there is a Jyotigram Yojana in Gujarat where each and every village, 18,000 village of Gujarat are getting 24 hours power supply in uninterrupted. If power goes, then it becomes a news in the Gujarat. This is the situation in Gujarat. The Gujarat government has done the innovative power things. Take the example of that is a solar energy power. Gujarat has done a biggest Asian power project in the Uttar Gujarat area from a solar energy. That is the biggest one in the Asia, and that has already started, and the power production has started. One more innovative things for Gujarat that is done is they have applied a solar plate over the Narmada canal. There is a length and breadth of the Narmada canal. It's a very innovative in the way that without using any another land, the same land is using, and the water which is flowing through the Narmada canal, it is prevented for evaporation.
Dr. Solanki, why do you think that Gujarat is able to do it and other states are not able to do it?
That's why I want to say, I want to come on this panel. For that you need to have a political will, and Gujarat has proved it. And now the budget, our finance minister is talking. They are just talking, while in the Gujarat it is already executed. So it is, what is the political
will?
You
mean to say it's about the states basically? If the state governments perform well, the scheme will certainly...
No, but if the state government can perform well, then why not center? Center have an enormous sort of a resources.
Center can seriously say that we have given you the money, it's up to you, it's in your hands.
Why the other states have not done it then? We have given.
Mr. Panda.
See, why the other state had not done?
Okay.
I would like to say that it is not just the subject of rural electrification. It's overall economic management, and it is not just Gujarat. There are about half a dozen states which are doing well. Gujarat is one of them. Odisha, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand. These are states that even today have 9.5% growth or even more. Odisha has just announced 9.5%. Bihar has announced 11%. These are states that are doing well. Because they are managing many of the economic issues very sensibly and with common sense, and also in a politically sustainable manner, because these are the regions where the regional leaders are getting re-elected time and again. Again, whether in Naveen Patnaik in Odisha, or Nitish Kumar in Bihar, or Mr. Narendra Modi in Gujarat and others. So, I want to dispel the notion that good economics is bad politics, which is what the central government seems to be doing for last several years. They are not learning from these various examples. Now, you asked specifically about rural electrification. You know, the point is, the attitude that you can micromanage sitting in Delhi thousands of kilometers away just doesn't work. It would be much better to devolve big chunks of funding and authority to state governments and to local governments like municipalities and panchayats, and let them decide what is their priority. Instead of, I'll give you one example. You've got a Rajiv Gandhi Vidyutikaran project. Now, of the various rural electrification efforts, that is, probably the least effective. It is in shambles. I don't know how it is in other states, but I can tell you in Odisha, in my constituency, you have electrical poles put up with no wires.
Right.
Sometimes you have wires put up, but they are not charged. Sometimes they are charged, but the distribution is so bad that the voltage doesn't sustain. So what we can do in the state government is, like they have taken certain steps in Gujarat, we have taken certain steps. We have listened to the experts that the distribution network needs to be stabilized. There is not enough investment in that. We are undertaking to invest massively in making sure that a large number of transformers are put up in all these panchayat areas, so that your voltage is sustained. If you can't do that, you can have surplus power, but you still cannot deliver. So the attitude that you can micromanage sitting in Delhi is no longer going to work. You have to think of much more devolution of authority and power. In Delhi, what you can do is you can de-bottleneck. You have seen in the power sector how many projects have got stuck because of the left hand fighting with the right hand within the government, environment ministry fighting with power ministry, National Highway Authority filing a case in the court against environment ministry, and you have dozens of such examples. What Delhi should do is stop infighting here and delegate the authority and the money, and then you will get far better results throughout the country.
But this is not the only case. We have heard of these stories of poles and disconnected poles, wires are missing, and other stories from different parts of the country, Mr. Yashki. But when it comes to power, one of the important problems is that power generation in the country in itself is a big challenge for us. Now we are talking about less import of coal. We want that we should increase our our own production, and we have to also ensure that we introduce PPP in that case. I mean, all these issues are interlinked, and let's look at the policy front. What Mr. Panda was saying, that probably we can't really make things here on paper sitting in Delhi and think of their good implementation in other parts of the country, but even while formulating it on paper, we'll certainly have to think about other aspects.
While thinking other aspects, is one of the remote village electrification is where, under Minister of Renewable Energy, central government is trying to sending an assistance of up to 90%. Those villages and hamlets were not covered, were unelectrified. Sending in the big assistance so that they can use other methods of renewable energies. The Ministry of Power, in 100 days, Mr. Sindhia yesterday was talking in one of the channels, how he has to fight with the environmental ministry to get those some of the clearances. Mm. So it is time for power ministry to think not just on the coal based or hydroelectrification, various other means of wind energy to, we have to think of other sources of getting energy.
Mm.
And particularly solar energy, which is need to be more prioritized.
Mm.
Obviously, ultimately, the states to implement it. If Rajiv Vidyut Gramin Vidyut Karan project is central government sending assistance to the state, it is not center directly involved in micromanagement. It is the states to do that. So if state employees or state government is more vigilant, such infiltrates can be stopped.
Hmm. What do you think about the, you know, the strengthening of the local bodies, whether it is the urban local bodies or specifically, since we are talking about the rural setup, the Panchayati Raj institutions? There is an important question today relating to the e-governance in panchayats. How do you look at this aspect of?
As visionary Prime Minister Mr. Rajiv Gandhi once said it, while strengthening the Panchayati Raj system, it is 1 rupee sent by the center. Mr. Panda just spoke about how this money has been wasted. Only 85 paisa is wasted on administrative cost, 15 paisa only reaching the beneficiaries. So the e-governance in panchayati level is very key importance for the development projects or money which is spending, because ultimately it is spent through the panchayat or jilla parishads. This is where Mr. Panda is mentioning about having less control from the center, localized, giving more powers to the local government and making them to more transparent and accountable and making them to be easy to govern.
But you know, there are problems like corruption increasing even in the panchayati raj institutions.
E-governance is the one source to cut the corruption and transparency.
After the last 4 years of one huge corruption scandal after another at the central government level, I don't think the central government can have any voice to say that there is corruption at panchayat level, that's why we don't want to send money. That's not the issue. There is corruption at various levels, but that doesn't mean you throw the baby out with the bathwater. You tackle the corruption and you find systems that overcome the corruption rather than saying we won't give money.
Hmm.
Here, we must be clear in understanding what is the various what are the responsibilities of the various state governments. Center cannot forcibly change the laws and give money directly to panchayats. The states actually have to enact those laws, and we must be frank, at many state levels, at the state assembly level, the MLA level, there is some resistance to further devolving because that they think dilutes their power. Some states are doing it. Kerala has done it. In Odisha, we have started giving more and more authority to the panchayat. For example, we are now shifting our PDS away from agents and into the hands of the panchayat so that they're accountable to their local village constituents. But the center can do lots more, which it is not doing. The center can incentivize this process. For example, on the urban side, in JNNURM, the center gives additional funds for those states where the urban bodies undergo certain modernization, certain changes in their legal structure. The municipal bodies have to have financial authority, they have to have administrative authority, they have to have some taxing authority. If the states make those legal changes, then the center gives them more funds. Similarly, this is where the center has not been aggressive enough. The center ought to prioritize and incentivize and give lot more funds to panchayats directly where the states are agreeable to devolve the authority and the budgets to the panchayats.
Okay, so there is also this panchayat sashaktikaran abhiyan, and also there is this puraskar that has been given also to the panchayats and the villages really performing well on the development parameters. It's time for a very short break in agenda. Please stay tuned for more.
आत्महत्या की बात की आपने, किसानों की क्या सबसे बड़ी वजह है ऐसी घटनाओं की जो होती हैं, खासतौर से आपके प्रदेश में, महाराष्ट्र में?
दिन ब दिन उर्वरक हो या डीजल हो या मजदूरी हो, इसकी कीमतें बढ़ती जा रही है, आसमान को छूती जा रही है, और लागत मूल्य से भी कम दाम मिल रहे हैं किसानों को, और इसका परिणाम ये हो रहा है कि खर्चा ज्यादा और उत्पादन कम.
वॉच नो योर एमपी फ्राइडे 8:30 PM only on Lok Sabha Television.
Welcome back to Agenda. In the list of business today, the supplementary demands for Grants Railways is also listed. If at all that thing takes place in the House, then we know that certainly the members will have their say on the railway budget too. Dr. Solanki, we would like to start it with you, sir. What was your view of the railway budget since the minister clearly said that the focus was on safety, consolidation, improving passenger amenities, and at the same time ensuring fiscal discipline?
No, I really welcome all these things, but see, they have talked regarding so many things, but not practically done anything. They have attached one anubhuti or coaches, but in fact it is nothing is there. See, regarding the price rise, the railway, recently before parliament, they have increased the rail fare, and in this budget, they claim that we have not increased the rail. They have indirectly increased. They have put so many taxes on different things, cancellation, tatkal, so many taxes. So it is all the load on this thing, the people, there is a load. The balance, the regional, ours is a federal structure. See, the central government is ruled by some other party, the state's government is ruled by other party, but they have to keep a rational balance in this thing. In this budget, there is some sort of a favorism is definitely seen in this budget. It should not have this. But particularly, I'm coming from Gujarat. In Gujarat, nothing is given. See, in the Western Railway, the major revenue comes from the network in the Gujarat, as Pandaji has said, for Odisha also. So the Gujarat, they have not given anything. No more new rail lines.
Gandhidham to Visakhapatnam,
and
covering the remotest area,
and the Saurashtra,
most backward area,
and Uttar Gujarat Kachariya are the remotest place. They are the backward place, but there is no rain collectivity.
Mr. Yashki, is obvious for them to expect a lot. It was after 17 years that a Congress minister was presenting the railway budget. But let's talk about the basic problems with the railways. It is always running short of the funds that it really needs to, do whatever they want to. And of course, it's always high on words, that's for sure. Because there are so many things that you have talked about, whether it's about the Wi-Fi facility that you want to introduce, special coaches or something, you want to fill in the vacancies, you want the disabled be rehabilitated there, and certain other things. But what about the basic problem, like, you know, the railway land lying just like that, not being utilized, the great word called PPP, which you really want to attract, and you yourself know that the private investors would not like to come and invest in the railways. How do you like to respond to those things?
Let me begin with the most critic of our government, Ms. Harsimrat Kaur, was saying this is the only first railway minister who did not had train to his hometown. So he rightly said it, he is thinking about the railway's future, financial sustainability. It is most important to have the railways to continues to have providing services to the people. Crores of people in the country, most cheapest transportation is railways. All these years, whoever become minister, they behaved like their railway minister for the state, not for the country. So what Mr. Bansal has did it here, as a able advocate himself, he has explained the problems in the railways, as you listed out, and to improve any amenities to the passengers, to the women's safety, to cleanliness, new coaches, new lines to be completed, we need money. Where do you get it? So earlier, without any rational thinking, announcing new projects and new lines, I disagree with Mr. Solanki, as I mentioned,
which
trying
has been
to
done
interrupt
even
him.
Now.
New trains has been started from Visakhapatnam to Gandhidham. It's 32 years people are fighting there. Yeah. His own party MP was saying, this is the first time the railway minister gave a train to us. So it is unfair him to say that we have left it out.
Okay,
let's hear a fair comment from Mr. Pandey. Listen. I have some strong opposition to the railway budget, but first let me try to be fair and compliment Mr. Bansal for two things. I also welcome, like Dr. Solanki, the emphasis on cleanliness, hygiene, security, which has been brought in. But this is, this is a much smaller part of the problem. There are many more fundamental issues that need to be done. And the one good fundamental thing he has done is he has put emphasis on building railway tracks in the border districts. Arunachal is now included for the first time. Jammu and Kashmir is getting more tracks. But this is where he has failed the rest of the country. Now, I told you earlier that in Odisha,
We have 8 districts that have no railways. These are tribal districts. And this is where you have naxalism because of lack of development. The railway has an obligation to be in those parts as well, so that we can over, you know, the economy in those parts can pick up. Now, I don't agree with my friend Madhu Gowd Yasky about the funding, because see, one of the things the railway minister said is that we must be pragmatic, and this is exactly what Mr. Yasky was saying. The problem is they're not being pragmatic. Now, take the case, I can give you the example of Odisha because I'm most familiar, but I'm sure there are repeats elsewhere. In Odisha, because we have a lot of minerals, they get a lot of business, lot of freight. And yet, they're building freight corridors elsewhere. Now, they're building the eastern freight corridor down to West Bengal, but we have been asking to extend it to Odisha. They're not extending it. Now, they're making huge profit from Odisha, 14,000 crores gross earnings. And they are not even investing 1,000 crores back in Odisha, which will first of all give them much more revenue because of the freight. And also it will serve the social purpose of these 8 tribal districts. You know, 1 crore tribals don't have access to railways. So they are neither, you know, meeting the social objective, nor are they actually acting in a pragmatic, rational fashion. So what happens is you have, you know, you have states like Odisha, which have the revenue potential, which have the social need, and yet we have much lower than the national average of railway tracks per square kilometer or railway tracks per population. So it's not enough to say that we don't have the money. Here the money is available, you have a social objective, you're still not doing it. And we have projects that have been going on for decades. Now we have a project to connect the relatively better off coastal Odisha to interior tribal Odisha called the Khurda Bolangir railway line. And you know what, that's been going on for decades and they've allocated only 3% of the budget this year. That's not rational.
Very quickly, closing remarks from you.
But the more trains are added from Visakhapatnam to many districts in Odisha, and I do agree with Mr. Jaipal,
but you have to
remote areas has to be given in a priority. And what Mr. Bansal tried to did it here, instead of just announcing a new project, he prioritizes some of the projects and allocated funds enough to complete those projects which is pending for 20 years or 30 years.
Okay, but on the ground level, the situation probably could be a little different, and the reality check has to be done by the government itself, Mr. Yasky. On that note, it's time here to thank you all. Thanks very much, gentlemen, for having you here. So that's all we have for you in this edition of Agenda. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.